Microwaves. Let's find out how they work.
Right. So microwave ovens, funnily enough, use microwaves. And they use microwaves because microwaves, like all waves, carry energy, and the energy heats the food.
And a microwave is what? A small wave? Well, that's what it means, microwave.
Absolutely, it does. It's micro because it's smaller than radio waves. So it's part of what's called a spectrum, electromagnetic spectrum, of which light, visible light, bang in the middle. Right. And then you've got radio waves at one end and gamma waves that they use in hospitals at the other end.
Right.
So microwaves are one down from radio waves. Micro because they're slightly smaller wavelength than radio waves.
And what does it...
But they're perfectly safe.
So how does it cook your food? They are safe, because people worry about
absolutely.
Microwaves.
I mean, visible light is an electromagnetic wave, and that's perfectly safe. So they're perfectly safe, but they cause heating effects.
Right.
So the way that the machine works is you've got this thing here, which is in the back of the microwaves. We've pulled it out the back, and that's called a magnetron.
Right.
It's a vacuum tube, and it produces the microwaves.
Yes. Righto.
And then inside... Inside the wall, you probably can't see, but it's, there's this little lump in there called a wave guide, and that guides the microwaves into the food.
Yeah.
And then all you've got here is this container, which contains the microwaves to keep them inside and shove them around the food.
So they don't come out.
And the, these microwaves have just the right frequency to be absorbed by the water molecules and the sugars and the fats, but specifically, particularly water in the food, and that excites the molecules, makes them really, really energetic, full of energy, makes them get hot, and that heat cooks the food.
There we are, to explain how different materials react and why it's very important to know what not to put in a microwave.
Yes.
We're going to demonstrate under carefully controlled circumstances. So do not try this at home. We're doing it here for you, so you don't have to. If you have any impressionable youngsters watching with you, then please make sure they don't copy what we're about to do. If you think they might, take them out the room, because we're going to put things in it that you really shouldn't put in it. The reason for doing this is to show what effect it has on different materials.
Exactly.
First thing we're going to use... I'm going to go right around the other side of this... stream, because you've told me to. So the first thing you're going to put in is what?
So everybody always says you mustn't put metals in the microwave. Now that is true, don't put them in. However, the inside of the microwave is actually made of metal.
Right.
So metal itself isn't a problem. Metals conduct electricity, and so when they absorb the energy from the microwaves, if they have any sharp edges like a fork, little prongs, the electrons in the metal will move around and they'll build up at the corners, and that could cause a dangerous build-up, and the electrons can jump across and cause a spark, which is called arcing.
Right.
But if you've got gentle, smooth surfaces like a spoon, it'll actually spread out the electrons so they won't build up and
it shouldn't spark. OK, we've got time to move on. So
to demonstrate it, we can use aluminium
foil.
Yes, we put aluminium foil, because that's got edges like a fork. We put it in here.
So what is going to happen to this? We're going to switch it on.
And I'm going to switch it on just for about 10 seconds, and you should see the sparks, the arcing, jumping across between the edges in the foil, just for 10 seconds.
Yep, there they go, look. You see it sparking.
Did you see the little spark?
I saw a spark.
That was
there.
It, that was the spark.
Just the one. Is that it? That's all we get.
Yeah, that's all we get from the
I've just told them our studio is going to blow up. They're deeply disappointed.
Turn it off?
But it's dangerous enough, yes, to turn it off. So that one's off, okay?
So you should have seen the little spark. That was a little spark of electricity jumping across from the edges where the electrons are building up on the edges of the foil.
Next thing?
So the next thing we're going to demonstrate is why would you, but you shouldn't put a CD in a microwave.
Yes.
Now, a CD is coated in aluminium.
We just thought there was a risk that you might, so we're going to show you why you shouldn't.
In case you were really tempted, don't do it.
No, right. It doesn't play music well at all, CD microwave. Go on.
So CDs are coated in aluminium, which, just like the metal in the foil, acts like a little antenna, and it absorbs the energy from the microwaves, and again, like that, you see the jumping of the sparks across. And they're actually jumping across from circular patterns, which is where the data is imprinted into the CD. And the spark causes the ions in the air around it to actually ionise, and you'll see flashes of light just for a few seconds around the CD.
And then what will happen?
And then it'll start to smoke, so we'll turn it off.
Oh, right, okay. So have you got one in there already?
There's one already set in there.
Right.
So all I'm going to do is press start. I'm going to put my gloves on just in case. So we just press go, and it's just going to go literally 7 seconds. So keep your eye on it, and you'll see a flashing light and a pattern around it.
Right.
So there we go. It's set up in there. There's the CD. And go.
So, oh, look at that. That's spectacular, isn't it? Oh, that was good.
And let's turn it off.
Oh, it's like Blackpool.
So all that happens next is it starts to melt.
But you're also getting noxious fumes off that as well.
So
again, another reason why you shouldn't do it. It's terrible.
Just so you can see, this is what the CD will now look like. And you can see that it's burnt... you can see a kind of little pattern of circles. That's where the data was burnt into the CD.
And the last thing you're going to put in there?
Yep. So the last thing is soap. Now, this is Ivory soap, which is a very light, fluffy soap.
Don't try and heat your soap. in a microwave. Heat it in a bath, OK? So tell us about this soap.
This will only work with soap that's very light and fluffy, and so you can tell because it will float on water in your bath.
Right.
So... Now, inside this soap, it's a kind of foam. So if you keep an eye on it, it'll take a few seconds to work. The foam is full of air and water, and the water gets really, really hot, and the air gets hot, and it forms little bubbles inside the soap, and because when air gets hot, it expands, it pushes on the soap, which has become soft by the heating effect of the microwave, making it pliable, and then the expanding air and water pushes out, puffing up to this enormous size, and there it is. Perfectly safe. It's just becoming a bigger and bigger, fluffier foam as those air bubbles inside expand as they get hot.
Yeah.
So if we take it out, give it another few seconds, you can take it out and have a look at what it looks like.
It's a wonderful air freshener.
We've got all of this fluffy foam. It's still soap, still does exactly what it should do. You can put it in the bath, but it's nice and fluffy.
Wonderful. There you are. Don't do anything. A reminder, do not try this at home with your bar of soap, with your CD, with anything except a mug of Bovril, OK? My thanks to Dr. Emily Grossman. Thank you, Emily.